All right, so before we get started, just reading my disclaimer here. All actions, movements, and material displayed and demonstrated in this presentation is information and not health or medical advice. The information provided does not take into account the needs or limitations of an individual and its exclusivity for use of residents of Manitoba. You should consult with your healthcare provider to reliance on the information. Anyone who relies on the information does so at their own risk. Any minors who view and rely on this presentation should do so under the supervision of a parent or guardian. Keeping that in mind, I mentioned I'm going to offer a lot of options, so choose which option feels best for you. And we're going to get started right now. Awesome. So it's noon, 30 minutes nonstop, and I promise we'll end with a really awesome stretch today. Okay, so for warm up, just find some space. Just gonna start nice and easy from the head here. So looking towards the floor, try to find your full range of motion. And then looking up again, nice and slow, try and find your full range of motion. So a little flexion of the neck, chin towards chest, and then looking up. One more, so just three of each here. And then looking side to side, so all the way to your left, and then all the way to the right. Noticing if one side feels a little tighter, maybe you have a bit more range on one side. Just moving nice and slow. Last time, first side. And then ear towards the shoulder. So try to keep your shoulders level, and again, just very gently moving slowly. We're stretching that lateral side of the neck. Should feel pretty good. One more, ear towards the shoulder. And then just relaxing, moving into some slow shoulder circles to start. So nice and wide, we'll circle back. Opening up tight chest, shoulders. And just be mindful, see how that feels in the shoulders. So take it nice and slow for the first few. And then we're going to reverse that. So circling forwards, separating those shoulder blades. Nice and slow. Find your full range. Two more. Keeping the arms relaxed. Nice and loose. We'll cut across the chest. You can alternate the arm that's on top. Just opening our chest very gently here. And then you have the option to open at different angles. Whatever feels good for you. We'll keep our arms loose. Stance is slightly wider than shoulder width. And add a little bit of rotation. So twist to the left, lift that right heel up, look to the left, and then pivot. Give the option to get those hips going. We're moving the torso. Arms are still loose. It's one of my favorites. Little gentle twist in the spine. One more rotation in each direction. And then coming to center, I'm gonna step back into just a half lunge. So step back with your right, and then reach that right arm up overhead, stretching that lateral side, hip flexor. Release, and then alternate. So just move at your own pace. For our lunge, it's just a light bend in that back knee. For now, we'll save the deep lunge for our workout. Just enough to feel that stretch, reach. You can push through that front leg, breathing out as you step together. One more. And then standing up nice and tall, lifting that left knee up, interlace your hands on your left shin bone. If you need to hang on to the wall chair, you can. Little balance challenge, so a split second hold. We're just gonna alternate today. So chest up, knee up. From the side, we're trying to keep that posture nice and tall. So we're bracing the core. I'm just adding some normal breathing throughout, so I'm not holding my breath. One more each leg. So drawing up, nice and tall. And I'm gonna end on my right. So I started with my left. And then finding a nice wide stance. It's a little side to side lunge here. You can keep your hands on your thighs if you want some support, eventually reaching towards the floor or the opposite toe. So again, still warming up, taking your time. Important for side lunge that you keep that whole foot firm. We're bringing our hips back so that knee is in line with the toe. It's not twisting in or jutting forwards. Hips back, one more each side. Good. A little hamstring sweep here, so go ahead and kick that left heel onto the ground. Soft bend in your right. So you push your hips back, so a little hip hinge, spine is straight. And maybe even sweeping the floor, circling overhead. We'll just alternate on the spot. Nice and loose. Spine is straight, hip hinge. Just warming up our legs. Total body, one more each leg. So left stretch, reach, right. And all right, we're gonna kick it up a notch. So first circuit, you have the option again to add some weight. So if you have a bag, I threw a couple textbooks in there. If you wanna grab cans, if you don't have textbooks handy, that works too. We're gonna warm up our deadlift. So option to do body weight, of course. Stance is slightly wider than shoulder width. If you are doing body weight, a little trick is to press the palms together, thumb on chest, index finger on chin, and then go ahead and take that hip hinge. So we're moving at the hips, bringing our hips above the knees, but below your shoulders, and then squeezing to stand. All right, we have 10 today, so a little more than last time. Again, option to hang on to something if you'd like. And here we go. So lowering, bracing that core. Find a good grip here. And then exhaling up, squeezing your glutes. Breathe in, tall posture. Breathe out. Gaze is just a few feet ahead. So you bring the head with you as you hinge back. Feel your whole foot firm on the floor. I got four more here. I'm squeezing for a split second at the top before I lower back down. Shoulders are directly over the hips. There's no hyperextension into the back. Last one, full squeeze at the top. And then moving the bag aside, we're gonna move into a prone. It's a single leg downward dog with a knee drive. So I'll demo the first option. So again, with a chair or some elevation, you'll find a nice high plank position. This can also be done on the floor. Pressing into a down dog position, so keeping the arms straight. Just gonna slide this back so you can see my feet. We're gonna lift one leg and then drive our knee towards that elbow. So you're gonna push your left heel back and then coming back into that high plank position. So again, option to do this on the floor, spreading your fingers, high plank, down dog, really extending through those arms, and then lifting left leg, elbow to knee. It's just five a side. It's harder than it looks. Definitely feel this into the shoulders, upper body as well. Just being mindful of your wrists, directly under the shoulders. Did a couple bonus ones elevated, so just five. If you need a shake in between before you get the other side, you can. Or if you want to, again, challenge yourself a bit more, you can go right into it. So right leg up, pressing into your hands a lot. And then right knee towards right elbow. Push your heel back as you extend those arms. Exhale, tuck. Two more on this side, keeping a lot of space around the neck. Last one, little hold, and then just a little shake. This next one is time, so I got the timer here. You can hang on to that bag if you want to add a little more resistance. We're just going to hover 20 second lunge on each side. Harder than it looks, but we're going to focus on squeezing our inner thighs, our core, really focusing on technique with this hold, building strength there. So it's 20 seconds a side, starting from the bottom up, so find a nice 90-90 position with your legs, body weight or weighted, and then from here, I'm just gonna hover that back knee off the ground. Looking straight ahead, again, squeezing your inner thighs, pressing into that front foot. Your back heel is straight up and down. 5 more seconds. Deep breaths. And lower. Little shake if you need. From here, you can just switch into the other side. 90-90, lifting in 3, 2, and hold. You're squeezing your inner thighs, pressing down. If you're hanging on to something, you can also push into that bag. Deep breath. A little harder on this second side for 4 seconds. No breaks until we're done here. 2, 1, and relax. Lower the weight if you have. Stand up and give your legs a little shake. About 10 second break between each round. We'll take a longer break once we're done all 3 rounds. Deadlifts, take 2. So 10 deadlifts. A little heavier if you have that resistance this week. Find your stance first, so it's slightly wider than shoulder width. Find a comfortable position for your feet. If you're hanging on to something, go for it. Make sure your spine is nice and straight before you even lift that weight, and then exhale up. Glutes are engaged for that split second before you move on to your next rep. Breathing out at the top. Hinging. So hips go back. You stay above the knees. You're below your shoulders, so you're not folding too far. About 45 degrees is great. That soft bend into the knee. And then extending to lock up for the last 3. Gazing a few feet ahead. 1 more. Holding it for 1 full second. And then releasing. We're back on the floor. Prone position. So high planks to start. You're going to find a downward dog. So if your hands are on a chair, that works too. Just going to push your hips back. Extend the arms fully. Press into those fingertips. This time, let's start with our right leg up first. And then knee drive. So right knee to right elbow. Exhale as you tuck. If you don't reach your elbow, that's okay. Just moving it towards that. So a little core, tons of shoulders, upper body in this movement. Last 2, so it's just 5 aside. It should be tough. 1 more. And then either moving into the other side or switching sides. Little break. Left leg up, left knee towards left elbow. Big push through those hands, extend that heel. Feel your glutes as you extend your leg. Strong hands on the floor. Last 2, exhale on that tuck. 1 more, last 1, we add a little hold just to finish it off, good form. And then just relax your wrists, your arms. Little shake, 20 second lunge, body weight or weighted, your choice. Find a 90-90, so start it from the bottom up. We'll start in 3, 2, and go for it. Hovering just an inch or 2, spreading your toes on that front foot, push down. Your back heel is straight up and down. You're squeezing your inner thighs for 4, 3, 2, and lower. Take a little recovery, little shake, deep breath. Set up side 2, starting in 3, 2, 90-90 with the legs, and then hover. So I'm keeping your chest up, I'm keeping my chest up. Make sure you squeeze that back glute, opening that hip. Tall posture. Last 3 seconds, you got it. Whew, it's getting a little harder each round. So one more round before we grab water. Just take 10 seconds here. You move around, maybe a couple steps side to side. It just helps to get that blood circulating, flowing. And you're gonna set up for your deadlift. So we've been doing two-handed deadlifts. If you're really comfortable with the deadlift, you can try a suitcase deadlift. So just bringing your weight to the outside of one side, and it would be five a side. So standing up, same position, hips come back, gaze is a few feet ahead, squeezing for 1 second at the top, keeping that breastbone lifted throughout. One more, just switch hands at the top if you're trying suitcase today. Keep going till you've done 10. Hinging, breathing, try not to hold your breath. Knees are nice and straight in line with your toes. Last two, really bracing that core. And relax. So a little breather. It's our last time for our prone or our high plank. Single leg dog, downward dog with a knee drive. So choose if you'd like to try this elevated today or maybe on the floor. Spreading your fingers a lot, high plank to start. So shoulders are over the hands and then lifting those hips back up into your downward dog, extending through the arms. Left leg lifts off the floor. Doesn't need to be high, just enough room to allow you to extend through that left heel, pushing that heel back, and then exhale, knee towards elbow. Move slow, really try and hit that hovering high plank in between each downward dog. So you got one more, it's just five per side. Option to take a break and reset, or maybe you're just gonna go right into the other side on your last round. Adding that exhale, you draw your knee towards your elbow, pushing your heel back, straight spine. It's really pressing through those fingertips, burning shoulders. You have one more. Don't forget to breathe. And then releasing your arms. You might need a little shake, holding yourself up. Really tough to do, builds a ton of upper body strength. Get my stopwatch here, so those lunges, everyone's favorite. You just have one more per side, 20 seconds, starting in 3, 2, and here we go. Finding 90-90, and then just hovering 1 inch off the floor. Option to hang onto something, or even body weight. Your body weight, maybe even bringing the fingertips to the back of the head, elbows back. 3 seconds, squeeze your legs a lot, and recover. Side two, we'll try body weight, but I'm gonna open up my tight chest in 3, 2, from 90-90 hover, squeeze that back glute, maybe fingertips behind the head, elbows back. Looking straight ahead, staying strong. Checking in. Try not to rest if you can. 3, 2, whew. Third round was definitely the hardest. But we get some water here, so you can walk it off, grab your water. Tough first set. How's everyone doing? How's everyone feeling? I'm sweating, I'm red as you can see. It'll be nice to step outside after this workout. Okay, new exercises. So we have time to get through 2 sets of this next circuit. I'm gonna start on the floor. dog he did a few weeks ago. This can be done from a nice tabletop position. So we'll all try that for the first round. Tabletop, wrists under shoulders, knees under hips, spreading the fingers. Option one, extending opposite arm, opposite leg, and then replanting and alternating until you've done five aside. Option two, sticking to one side for five aside, elbow towards knee under the torso, push your heel back. So we want to prevent teetering side to side. So two more on one side or 10 total. You're alternating, trying to keep that stable arm nice and straight, soften the joints. Switch sides if you are sticking to single-sided. Straight spine before you move into that next breath. Adding some breath. Last two. Space around the neck. One more. Push your heel, little hold. And relax. Squats. So again, option to add some resistance if you have that weighted bag. Just gonna hold that in front of the chest, however is comfortable. Stance is slightly wider than shoulder width. So different from our deadlift, we're gonna sit back into an imaginary chair, but bring our hips a lot lower. As low as you can, keeping that nice straight spine, low back, and then exhale up. So five, weighted if you can, or body weight. And then we're going to do two optional squat jumps or a little more power in our squat. So one more weighted. Adding just a couple power moves. So you can either do standing up with a little bit more speed. If you want to add a squat jump, you can do that too. It's just two. Just two after that squat. And everyone's favorite, tempo push-ups. So again, we did this a couple weeks ago. Round one, I'll demo elevated. Use the bottom of your stairs, a chair, or the floor. So find a nice high plank position. Just building on that high plank. Shoulders are directly over the wrists. Our stance will be a little wider for this. We're gonna move a little slower, lowering for three, two, one, elbows come back about 45 degrees, and then pressing, three, two, one. So we have five, two, one, little pause, three, two, up, 3 seconds down, 3 seconds up, split second hold, so a lot of core, squeeze your quads, glutes, abs for these last two. Nice and slow. Keeping your neck neutral. So just gazing straight down. And definitely give your arms a little break. We're just gonna repeat that. So we're back on the floor for our bird dog quadruped. If you wanna try it, a little harder to hover from your toes, but you can. We have that option too. High plank position. And starting with just alternating. So these are moving really slow. Or maybe you're just gonna stay on the ground today. Working some single side. Once you feel really stable in quadruped on your knees, you can try it on the side or standing on your toes. Which is a lot harder. Focusing on full extension before you make that next connection. It's just five, so you have one more, unless you're alternating back and forth. And then a little break for the wrists, hands. We're back to our weighted squat jumps, so five. Then you have the option to add two, either jumping or just exploding, standing up a little faster. So I'm gonna throw my bag in my hand for the first five, finding that stance and then lowering to your end range. Everyone's end range is a little different. As long as you keep that posture nice and tall, that low back nice and flat. And knees tracking with those toes. So there's no buckling in or out. Last two, and then you can decide. Last one, power. So release your weight. Standing up with some speed or taking two squat jumps. That's it, little shake. Last exercise before we cool things down. So we have our push-ups. Because they're tempo, you want to keep our form. If you want a little bit of elevation, that's great too. 3 seconds down, slight hold, 3 seconds up. You can follow my lead or move at your own pace. Find your high plank first. And here we go. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, up. Breathe in, hold that core nice and strong. Exhale, press. See if you can add that split second hold. And now check in, are your quads engaged? Are your glutes engaged? You're still bracing that core. Last one as slow as you can. Maybe that extra hold. And then as slow as you can to lift. And then relax your hands. So tough. Grab some water. Just want to check in with everyone. So if you have time to do that one more round, go for it. But yeah, total body today. Lots of challenges with tempo. We added that hold. So it's a great way to add some strength into your regular routines. Before we sign off here, we're going to get into a nice, awesome stretch. So again, find some space. Have a yoga mat free, or maybe even a pillow, something for your knee. I'm gonna start off with our half kneeling stretch. So again, 90-90, just like our bottom up lunge, engaging your glute so you can really open up that hip. Feel that just below your hip bone. Part of the recovery is slowing down your breath. So while you're kneeling, taking those deep breaths. One more breath, and then we'll move into a nice slow lunge here. So for low lunge, you can either step forwards or bring your knee back a touch. And bring both hands on the inside of our left foot evenly. So that could be fingertips or flat hands. Maybe you even bend your elbows and just relax your back toe and your neck. You should feel that a little more into your quad, maybe even your left hamstring. One more breath, and then to come out, just walk your hands back nice and slow and safe. We'll bring our hands onto our knees, and then we'll spin it to get the other side. So again, starting in 90-90, engage that left glute, open that tight left hip. So focusing on hip flexor stretch below your hip bone. And then just sitting or looking straight ahead. So we're nice and tall. Heart rate should be a little slower. One more breath, and then we'll find our low lunge. That could be a step forwards or even just bringing your knee back. Both hands even on the inside of the right foot, fingertips, maybe flat hands, and then allowing that hip to drop, relaxing your head. Taking a couple deeper breaths. If you'd like to exhale out through your mouth, it can help relax your jaw. So maybe trying that here. And then to come out safe, just walk back a couple steps with your hands. You can bring your hand to your knee. And we're just gonna turn to face forwards, frog pose, really awesome hip opener. A lot of people really find it challenging but end up loving it, so go ahead and try it. Again, making sure you have a little bit of cushion for your knees, so yoga mat folded, if you're on carpet that might work, or pillow. Bring our knees uncomfortably wide, and then for today, let's bring our big toes to touch. Coming onto our forearms, rocking forwards and back. Just take a couple rocks. This time we'll stay back and bring our hands back so we can rest our head. So it could be stacked fists or flat hands. I'll let you decide. Keep holding that. While you're breathing, I'd like you to try breathing into your belly. Slight pause and then relaxing completely. Just to again help stimulate some relaxation in this tight hold. So we'll take one more breath here. When you relax, maybe out through the mouth. So come out safe on our hands first. That way we can place our body weight in our hands. And then very slowly bring your legs together. And just extend your legs to release them from that deep stretch. Last one, we'll end seated. So something comfortable. You want, you can sit cross-legged or maybe legs out in front. I'm just going to take a few deep breaths to again check in, make sure our heart rate is down. So from here, try breathing in for 1, 2, 3, slight pause, and then exhale, belly in for 3, 2, 1. So one more on your own here, deep breath in. Slight pause and then exhale. And feel free to stretch anything else that's tight. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you're as sweaty as I am, and yeah, have a wonderful weekend. We have classes Monday, Wednesday, Friday at noon next week, so check those out and enjoy your weekend. If you have any feedback, feel free to comment below. We always take a peek at those. And yeah, hope you're doing well. And thanks for joining me. See you next week.